been a lot of talk about this next song. Maybe, maybe too much talk. This song.
Sometimes when I'm sitting in my room or even here, everything takes this dream-like quality. The people, the room, everything. Like it wasn't really happening. Like a plugs become disconnected. At first I could snap out of it almost immediately, but then the next couple of times it hit me and I couldn't shake it. This feeling of sheer terror came over me. God, I didn't know what to do. I couldn't think. I couldn't move. I just felt lost. I sit there panic-stricken for no reason at all. Is this normal? People around me would go about their business. I don't think they even knew what was going on or if I had a problem, but yeah. It would eventually pass and back to the silence I would go. Frozen in time.
I'm feeling high.
Like two shades away from the life you're supposed to be living. I'm there. Sometimes I'll look back, like right now, usually when it hits the fan and I think about my past and where I went off track, I try to pinpoint the place in my mind where it began, because I know I was on the right path at some point. Just something happened along the way that just bumped me over a bit, and here I am, wondering if I add up, wondering if I'm ever going to get back on the right track again. Can't I just have a normal life? Why can't I just go out and do the things I want to do? I'm not happy. I don't care about my education and being kind and having morals and values. I want to act on my impulses. I want to live my own life experiences, and I am tired of being held back. There shouldn't be anything wrong with a young woman finding her own way, deciding who she wants to be as she grows up, without having all these criticisms put on me. I want to be left alone, free to be my own person and make my own decisions and go my own way. I am tired asking for permission and tired of sneaking around to have a laugh with my friends, and it makes me feel like I'm doing something wrong. No, I don't want to listen. Understand? I think I finally found it. My reason. My muse. We don't make art. Art makes itself through us, but we have to be open enough to let the muse in. I mean the state of being, where it's not just doing it, time passes and you didn't notice. It's like you're in a trance and you come out and you feel like you were led on by the forces beyond you. You've been touched by God. It doesn't happen every time, for some people almost never, but it's the reason to make something. It's the dirty little secret of why people are really artists. It's the chance you get. That high you get from the certain creation when you're with the muse or with God or whatever you want to call it, really. And you come out and you're like, how did I just do that? It couldn't have been me. It must have been someone else. I think athletes know about it too. Scientists, mathematicians, they all know what it's like to get in the zone. It's just that for me, that certain thing is from creating or painting or sculpting or filming. But the muse won't come if you're too busy thinking about your critics. It's why some artists drink. Shuts up the critical voice for a while, but at first, but it destroys you in other ways. I don't know. Not an alcoholic. But I'm addicted to making art with my muse. If only you could access that all the time. But you can't. Or at least I can't. That's the flaw of criticism. Think the artist is creating something for you, but she's not. She's feeding her own addiction. Art is just the byproduct of the process. The art is for the artist.
She calls me day and night. I'm sorry, girl, you just don't.